Hello friends, welcome. Just making a sort of vloggy video this Sunday's video. It's Wednesday at the moment. Just in my front room where I do my filming, just show you around. So, got my bit on my door. Somebody said that looked like a washing machine. Made out of oil drums they are. In the Caribbean. That's me as a shepherd. Back 1986. Again, that's me in 1986. My hair's a bit windblown as usual. That's one of my sheepdogs. I just got, I got fourth place that year at the sheepdog trial. Got a couple of third places with this dog. He was a really good dog, great sheepdog. Just got a picture of a Japanese lady. You know, I'm married to my spirit wife, Su Ling, in spirit. So this is my studio, just got a box light here. All this acoustic foam is just to stop the echo in the front room, which is a bit on this camera, I expect. But I've also got some fleece up on the ceiling here, just to stop the echo up this end so that it doesn't echo too much. Got a nice light source coming in the front window, just to illuminate things a bit. So I just turned that one box light on. Just I've got a second one, but then I do a nice white balance. So you got the card there. I've turned it around at the moment, but I do a white balance on this side on the camera just to get the colours right on the video. I've covered all the furniture with fleeces and the seating area with fleeces so that it doesn't get too echoey. This is where I sit and do my filming in here, in my chair. I don't spend much time in this room. So this is the microphone, just on this stand here. Just a shotgun mic, just have it over the top of me here, just out of camera. About here somewhere. Just so it picks me up alright. Got a little hair light there. Just turn on. I expect it's just about flat by now. Yeah. It just lights your hair up a bit, which makes it stand out from the background a bit. So, yeah, just sort of sit back here in the chair, making my videos. And got a little Japanese lantern. Got my meditating man with some crystals and a little sticky lights. So I moved to this position here because it was straight in front of the window. I was in this corner and it was too bright one side of me, and then I was in that corner and it was too dark. So now we're just going in the middle here, and this is the sort of angle you get of me, sort of like that. I used to have my plaques behind me because I was over there, but I've moved my they're actually paving slabs, these, to go up in the garden. They're really heavy, so you wouldn't want to drop one on your toe too much. But where I used to be a shepherd, I used to collect a few sheepdogs and stuff. So, got a Buddha. That's a picture of Peter Citadel. It's a very good likeness of him. He awoken me to spirit in 1995 and was the son of God here. Lovely man, that was him when he was about 50 years old. So I've just got a few bits, and my friend did that, it's a psychic drawing of him. Said he was pulling his nose and had his tongue in his cheek as he was doing it. And that's her rendering of Jesus Christ. Whether it's accurate or not, I don't know, but we'll see. So, that's it. Peter, most lovely man, that's my mum when she was 21. So that's, I love tigers as well, so sort of covered them over a bit. But I got my little gem tree. So some nice stuff. I got this at Glastonbury, when I went up to Glastonbury. Everybody said what a lovely vibration it was up there and how spiritual it is at Glastonbury. And I got Glastonbury Abbey and Glastonbury tour, and I went up the tour, went around the Abbey, and just in the last 10 minutes I was there, just before we were going to leave, I went for a little walk on my own and went up this side street, and I felt such a beautiful vibration all of a sudden, so it's lovely. Yeah, so that's the dining room, front room, but I don't use it much, filming studio and entertainment. So that's it. Yeah, I mean, I wanted to talk about spirituality and stuff, so spiritual development, really. I mean, you know, what is spiritual development? What is being spiritual? Well, it's a way of life, isn't it, being spiritual? I mean, we are spiritual beings in the physical body. If you start to think about it, you know, what is my purpose here in life? What is the purpose of life? And, you know, is there more to life than just, you know, life and death? Well, yeah, there is. I mean, there's a continuation of life hereafter, and continual evolution is possible. So we can evolve and evolve and evolve until probably we get something like Father God. So that would take a very long time to achieve, wouldn't it? So we're here, and the physical body masks the spirit quite a lot. It makes our abilities a lot less evidential. But we can develop them, you know, and we can also develop a way of living life in a much more spiritual way. And to me, the key to living a more spiritual life is really, you know, love. Because if you love yourself and heal yourself of any, you know, negativity you might feel, any sadness, any things that you're going through, but also learn to love those around you, forgive those that trespass against you. So learn to love, and you forgive people, won't you? And you won't hold grudges, because love does no harm to nobody, does it? So you learn to love, and you're gonna do no harm in the world. Love is a great educator to be more responsible. That we think about what we're eating, we think about how we treat others, we think about what we're doing to the planet, so we're more responsible individuals through love. But it does no harm. So love thy enemy, yes. You know, because if you hate them, you're just generating and sending negativity at them. And if you love them, then the chances are one day you might be able to befriend them again and live in peace. So love is the saviour of this world and every other, because the more people that love, the better. And love is one of the greatest spiritual assets you can ever have. Because it's like, if you're a healer, if you just heal a patient without any real connection to them, it works, but not that well. But if you heal a patient with love and compassion and wanting to help their ailments, that it transmits to them a lot stronger. So love's the real key to saving this world and developing ourselves, because you cultivate love inside yourself and it leads you into becoming more spiritual, doesn't it? Because being more spiritual is about a way of life of living more peacefully and more lovingly here on this world, being more aware of our own actions and how we react to others. So many of the good teachers have said it, like, you know, Christ and Buddha, love those that you might feel negativity at. Don't respond to negative people with negativity, respond to them with positivity. So we have to sort of rise up out of the quagmire of negativity, because it's a very easy thing to be negative, and look at developing our positive nature, our nature of light, because there is darkness within everything, within ourselves. So that's why we can be negative at times, because there is darkness there. So it's keep developing yourself to have a lighter nature and a more loving nature, and you're on the right path. Because when you choose to start developing yourself, you will find that things will open up to you. And as you start walking the path of spiritual development and spirituality, cultivating all these good things of spirit, that you will have a lesson. And then one day you will learn that lesson. And then if you ask for the next lesson, it will come by opportunity. Suddenly you come across a set of circumstances that gives you opportunity to learn something new and a new lesson to help cultivate and develop yourself. So that's it, you know, look for the lessons in life each day. Draw back your curtains in the morning, embrace the new day with the positivity and say, what can I learn from life today? How much can I better myself today? And one little step at a time, you will become ever more increasingly spiritual and more developed and opening up to a lot of good things in life. So love and light to you. Bless you. Thanks for watching. Neil.